cause you better not make me cry. I really hope y'all do like this recipe cause I've cried like 3 times for y'all.
See what she makes for y'all? This is what I eat.
You chose to eat that.
No, the ramen life chose me. I didn't choose the ramen life.
Baby, don't act like I don't take care of you in front of these folks. What's wrong with you? And then they know you fine because I post you on my social media, so they over there. If she don't want to take care of him, I do it. Pass it to Denise. I already know. I know what you hussies thinking. Hey y'all, like this? Got it from Mexico. So authentic. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's me, Brittany, aka Pineapple Vegan, and we're back with another video. And today we are making Taco Bell inspired taco crunch wrap. Know what I'm talking about? Yes. Yes, and y'all, this is better because it's at home and you're making it authentic style with your own touch of love in it. All right, guys, so the items that you will need or that I'm using, first, I'm gonna start with my extra large tortillas. You need some tomatoes. I already washed and diced mine up. And I have some jalapeno, so I'm actually not adding it to my crunch wrap. You can add it to yours, but what I did was added it to my cheese mix, and I'm gonna tell you more about that cheese mix in a second. Minced garlic, vegan crumbles, like vegan meat replacement if you choose. You can just use black beans if you want. Tostadas, diced small sweet yellow onion. Lettuce of your choice. I just used a spring salad mix. Salsa of your choice. I have some traditional medium and some black bean and corn salsa. And I have some leftover black beans that I didn't get to use, but waste not, want not, right? You need some pink Himalayan sea salt, black pepper. You can use any taco seasoning that you want. This is my own taco seasoning that I make myself. And Sazón. It is Goya brand Sazón. It's a Hispanic seasoning. I love it, adds extra spice and flavor. You don't have to use this, but I recommend it. And oil. So I actually found this cute little misto that I can actually put my own oil in. So I just mixed avocado and olive oil in this. So let's get started. I have my pan already heating, so I'm just gonna lightly spray my pan. We're gonna put the garlic in first on our already hot pan. As much or as little as you want. Let that get a little fragrant. Add your onion. I'm just gonna saute that a little bit. Let that get brown a little bit. Translucent if you can. And while this is sauteing, I'm gonna tell you about my cheese sauce. So this cheese sauce is just follow your heart shreds that I melted over a saucepan with boiling water in it. And I added some chunky salsa. Look at that. So good. Okay, so now my onions are pretty fragrant. I really wish you guys could smell it. It smells so good in here. I'm gonna get my beefless grounds. I'm using Gardein. You can use whatever kind you want. I just like Gardein. It smells so good. And I actually sat this in the fridge for a couple hours so it wouldn't be frozen. I'm actually gonna add a little bit more olive oil. I want my sauce to be a little wet. And I'm not fooling with that spray right now because I didn't read the instructions on how to use it. And I was trying to be fancy and show y'all my new toy and I don't even know how to use it. So yeah, there you go. And now I'm gonna add a little bit of my salsa. Add as much as you want or don't add any. It's up to you, shawty. YOLO, do what you feel. Whatever you want. Now, we're gonna add our seasonings. So let me add my taco seasoning. I like a lot, obviously. It's not a lot of sodium in my seasoning. Actually, I didn't put any salt in my taco seasoning because I'm trying to stay away from a lot of sodium. As you can see, there's no garlic salt on this counter. Yeah, okay, black pepper. And this, there's so many flavors in this recipe. You don't need a bunch of stuff. And my pink Himalayan sea salt, just a little. And just cook it through a little bit more. Y'all, this is such a quick recipe. Okay, and I'm gonna make a little hole in the center. And I'm gonna add my leftover black beans. And then I'm gonna add my sazón. You don't have to use a whole pack, but who am I kidding? It's me. So this is pretty cooked through. So I'm gonna go ahead and take this off of the heat. And I have to heat up my press. So I'll be right back, you guys. Okay, you guys, so while we wait for my press to warm up, I'm gonna go ahead and assemble my tostada or my crunch wrap. And I decided to go ahead and add some Tofutti vegan sour cream to it as well. This is optional. Just make sure you mix it up really well because it comes really blocky. Make it real creamy. I'm gonna put it on 350. And you can use any press that you want. If you don't have a press, you can just use a skillet. You will just put your crunch wrap as you fold it, the folded side down, okay? So let's go ahead and start. We're gonna get our tortilla. And what I'm gonna do is just put a little bit of sour cream in the center, almost like a glue. Just a dot, not a lot. And then we're gonna go ahead and put in our taco meat mixture. As much or as little as you want. Don't be scared, but just make sure that it can close. You don't wanna overstuff it. Okay, and I like to add my cheese next. Add your cheese on there. There's no fancy way to do this. And then we're gonna add our lettuce or spring mix, whatever you chose to use. And then our tostada, okay? Be gentle. And now we just fold it over. As best as you can, y'all. It's almost like a little blanket situation. That's how I do it. I just fold and tuck each side. And then you get your cooking spray, spray your pan, and then you have to put it face down so that it can seal. And then close and press. Not for long, it does not take much. I'm gonna go ahead and start building another. And you guys, this is such a quick and easy meal. Like, and the money you would spend to feed your whole family at Taco Bell or any restaurant, you can spend way less or even the same amount and have more servings in it, you know? Cheese. And also, you don't have to build yours the same way I built mine. You could switch it up a little bit, you know, go crazy. Doesn't have to be just like mine. My kids are gonna murder these.
Murder, murdered who?
Murder. Okay. Let's do it again. Gotta hurry up because I don't want to burn it. Then y'all gonna be laughing at me. There we go. Ooh. Ooh. About to make the rest of them. One of my sons, he does have a mild gluten intolerance, and I don't really want to give him the flour tortillas if I don't have to. But all I'm going to do for him is I'm going to take a tostada, and I'm just going to put sour cream on top of it, and I'm just going to get some with the cheese. The lettuce and the tomato, and all he'll do is just put a little salsa on top, and he's gonna eat a tostada instead of the crunch wrap. Okay, I'm gonna try it even though it's still hot. Ooh. Oh my god. Oh my goodness. Y'all, this is good. I don't even have salsa on it. It's better than what I said. This is good. I know I always do this to y'all, but I mean it this time. Here, have a bite. No, for real, have a bite. Fight! I'm sorry. As you can see, this was a very easy recipe. Very quick, simple, made a lot of food. I still have stuff left and I made a lot. My kids have had seconds. Give this recipe a try, and if you do, please let me know how you liked it. Post it on your social media and tag me at @pineapplevegan, and let me know what you thought about it, you guys. If you haven't already, go ahead and subscribe to my channel. And if you like this video and you want to see more like it, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. And as always, bye guys, I love you. I miss you already. Bye. Bye. Come take a bite.
I need
to taste something. Take a bite. Take a bite.
Yeah.
Mm. You like it, stink? Yeah. You want the rest of it?